Hello everyone, welcome to all. In this session, we are going to discuss about what is the relation between the E, C and K. What is the relation between the Young's modulus as well as the modulus of rigidity and bulk modulus. Okay, so in the last class we have discussed about the composite bus. At the same time, stresses due to tightening of the nut and temperature stresses. Okay, so in this class we are going to discuss about the relation between the E, C and K. E, C nothing but the Young's modulus, rigid modulus, at the same time Poisson's ratio. Poisson's ratio or the bulk modulus. Okay, so lateral strain is nothing but the, so whenever the body tends to change in the length direction, we can call it as a longitudinal strain. Okay, whenever the body tends to change in its diameter, okay, so we can call it as a lateral strain. Okay, laterally. Okay, longitudinal is nothing but in the length direction. Lateral is nothing but the in volume direction, I mean diameter direction. Okay, so and the Poisson's ratio. Poisson's ratio is nothing but the, here the formula is there, lateral strain by longitudinal strain. Lateral strain is the, here is the, this is the lateral strain. Okay, and the longitudinal strain is the in the lengthwise direction. Okay, so this is the relation. So what is the relation between the lateral strain to linear strain? Okay, longitudinal strain or linear strain, we can call it as a linear strain. So the ratio between the lateral strain to the linear strain, you can call it as a Poisson's ratio. Okay, for every material we have some kind of some amount of Poisson's ratio. Okay, for the circular bar, the lateral strain will be delta D by D. Okay, for the rectangular bar of thickness T, so in this situation lateral strain will be the delta T by T or delta B by B. Okay, so is the changes from the body to body. If in case of circular, delta D by D. If in case of rectangular, the lateral strain will be the delta T by T. Okay, so the value of the Poisson's ratio, the most material, varies from the 0.23 to 0.35. This is the most acceptable range for the Poisson's ratio. So in the next so we have a data regarding every material: aluminium, brass, copper, steel, cast iron. Okay, among those five materials, Young's modulus, steel has a higher Young's modulus, is equals to 2 into 10 to the power of 5. Okay, that much of amount of Young's modulus it has. Okay, so is the volumetric strain nothing but the volumetric strain of circular bar subjected to axial stresses. Here the axial stresses, longitudinal strain equals to delta L by L is equals to sigma by E. What is meant by delta L equals to change in length. Okay, and then lateral strain equals to delta D by, is the first one is the longitudinal strain. And then lateral strain equals to delta D by D is equals to 1 by M times of sigma by E. Okay, 1 by M will be added. The original volume of the bar equals to pi by 4 D square into L. The original volume of the bar. Okay, volume is nothing but the cross sectional area into L. Okay, then the final volume of the bar equals to here the V1 equals to final volume of the bar after expansion of, okay, so final volume is nothing but the after expansion of the load, after expansion of length, pi by 4 capital small d minus delta d whole square is nothing but the lateral strain. Okay, and L plus delta L. So we can redefine as the pi by 4 d a minus b whole square. Okay, d square L plus d square into delta L minus 2L d delta d. So by just simple, we just derive the a minus b whole square formula and multiplied with L plus delta L. Okay, so here's the neglecting product of small quantities, change in volumes. Here the delta V equals to pi by 4 small quantities change in by neglecting product of small quantities. Small quantities nothing but the here is the d square delta L will be same. Minus 2 LD delta D will be the same. Here the small quantity is the d square into L will be this small quantity. That's why it is we just neglect the. So these are the derivations part of the concepts. So try to understand it's a very fast forward. Okay. Change in volume equals to pi by 4 cap small d square delta L minus del 2 L D and delta D. Okay. The volumetric strain equals to dV by V delta L by L minus 2 E delta D by D. So change in volume by original volume equals to nothing but the change in length to original length minus 2 times of D. So 2 times of 2 delta D by D. So here E minus 2 times of delta L. Though E is nothing but the sigma by E minus 2 times of EL is a longitudinal strain, sorry, lateral strain. Lateral strain is nothing but the sigma by MA, which is observed here. Okay. And volumetric strain is equals to sigma by E is multiplied by 1 minus 2 by M. Okay. Now volumetric strain is a rectangular bar subjected to axial stresses. If in case of up to now we have considered about the volumetric strain equals to sigma by E 1 minus 2 by M. In the case of the circular bar, if in case of rectangular bar, the formula will be the here. Okay. Here the formula will be the final change in volume equals to sigma by E 1 minus 2 by M. So here's the, so we can observe the for the two materials we have a same change in volume, change in strain. Okay, volumetric strain. So sigma by E 1 minus 2 by M. Here also sigma by E 1 minus 2 by M. If in case of volumetric strain rectangular bar subjected to triaxial stresses, it's nothing but before that. Here is the original volume of the rectangular is LBT. The final volume is L plus delta L. Okay. The change in length. Okay. Final volume. Initially L. So why we are taking positive for the L? Why we are taking negative for the lateral direction? Why? Because if in case of apply, so here though we just consider an assumption, which is we always applied a tensile load. Due to tensile load, the final due to the tensile load, the body has a initial length of L. After the application of load, the body has a change in length of delta L. So the final value, final length will be the initial length plus change in length. Okay, that is, that's the reason length has been increases, but the B, which is nothing but the breadth and as well as the thickness, these two parameters goes on decreases. That's why we are taking negative sign here. Final volume equals to here. So by simply applying the mathematical derivations here, mathematical solutions. So dV is equals to BT delta L. This is we are nothing but this, neglecting some small quantities of products. Okay, the final volume will be the volumetric strain equals to dV by V is nothing but the delta L by L minus delta T by T minus delta B by B. So it's nothing but the difference between the summation of difference between the change in length, change in thickness, or change in breadth. Okay. So E minus EL minus EL. Okay. EL nothing but the lateral strain in terms of thickness, lateral strain in terms of breadth. Sigma by E, 1 minus, minus sigma by ME, minus sigma by ME. So just considering a sigma by E common, the remaining will 1 minus 2 by M. Now volumetric strain of rectangular bar subjected to triaxial stresses. So in this situation, volumetric strain of rectangular bar subjected to triaxial stress. The bar, rectangular bar has subjected to initially up to now we had discussed about the bar which is subjected to only axial stress, single axis. So and now we are going to analyze about the what will happen. The body is has experienced three triaxial stresses. So the loads are acting in the three direction. So what will be have? So in the situation, volumetric strain equals to ex plus epsilon. We can call it as E, or we can call it as epsilon also. Ex plus Ey plus Ez. So summation of the all directions, the strain in all directions. So here also, Ex equals to strain in the direction of x. So strain in the direction of x, we can call, we can rewrite as, in case of x, even while we considering the x direction also, the influence of other forces upon the x direction will be present. So that's why reason we are, even we consider in x direction also, the remaining forces are also considered in terms of Poisson's ratio. Poisson's ratio is nothing but you just applied, you just add your Poisson's ratio to the respective directions. Okay, suppose the sigma x by e minus here, in case of y element, we just add your 1 by m. Okay, 1 by m is nothing but the Poisson's ratio, lateral strain by linear strain. Okay, minus sigma z by me. Okay, so initially sigma x by e is which is acting on the x direction, and the sigma x by y by e, which is multiplied by 1 by m, you can call it as a y direction. Strains acting on the y direction. Okay, this is the equivalent equations. Okay, equilibrium equations, which we will discuss later in the offline classes. Okay, how it will comes. Okay, why? Because it has some basic derivations which are not able to explain in the online mode. Sigma z by me. Okay, see here though, we just this is the equilibrium equation. Firstly, we just considering sigma x by e, and in case of while we considering the remaining directions also, just adding a Poisson's ratio here. Okay, so by simply solving, sigma x minus mu times of mu is nothing but the we can our mu is equal to 1 by m. Okay, in terms of 1 by m, we just replaced with mu. Okay, sigma by simply deriving equations, sigma x plus sigma z by e. Okay, similarly ey equals to strain in the direction of y. Okay, here it is strain in the direction. Simply you just if in case of y direction also, sigma y by e minus m times of 1 by m times of sigma x by e minus m times of sigma z by e. Here the with respect to y direction only, here it will come. Okay, if in case of z direction, the first term will be the sigma z by e. If in case of y direction, the first term will be the sigma y by e. Okay, like this one. So after those equations, substituting these values in equation of one, so is nothing but the substituting these values, sigma x, sigma y, sigma z values, in the equation of sigma of initial equation, standard equation, the total volumetric strain equals to the volumetric strain, summation of volumetric strain in the each direction. Okay, after that one we have a note that which is the dv by v is equals to sigma x plus sigma y plus sigma z by e, 1 minus one minus two mu, or one minus two by m. So we can remember anything. Okay, 1 minus 2 mu or 1 minus 2 by m. So mu equals to 1 by m here. Okay, we can call it as a Poisson's ratio. That's enough. Relation between the elastic constants. So here, you just remember. Hope you remember this one. So here, the every concept you have your formula. So here, the most of the cases, the number of the concepts rises to number of the problems here. Okay. So we'll go through the problems. We need to know formulas. Basically, the entire mechanics of solids is only depending upon the how much you know the formulas, how do we use the formulas. Okay, so how do we apply the formulas in the critical situation, in the regarding critical problems. Okay, completely depends upon the formulas. Okay, relation between the elastic constants E, C and K. Here is, so initially we have considered a rectangular bar here, whether it may be square or cube. Okay, consider a cube of ABCD which is distorted to a position of ABCD by shear stress. Okay, after application of shear stress, suppose we just applied a shear stress here. Shear stress nothing but where not only the not only in the longitudinal direction, we can obtain it as a transverse direction also. The shear stress will be acting like this one. Okay, so initially after the application of load, the position of the bar, position of the cube will be the ABCD. After application of load, the position will be changes from original position to some inclination position, like AB from B, which is initially B is there. After application of load, the B will be moved to some distance B dash. Okay, after C, which is moved to some distance C dash. Okay, like this one. So this is the, what is the relation? This is the angle of phi. This is the angle of phi. Angle of phi is this. What is the shear strain? Okay, angle phi is nothing but the shear strain. How much angle it deviates? Okay, so CE is the perpendicular on the position of diagonal AC. As you know that CE is the perpendicular. CE, which is, this is the CE, which is perpendicular on new position of diagonal AC. Okay, while we draw a perpendicular diagram on the AC dash. Okay, but since angle CAE is very small, CAE is very small, and so that's why reason AC equals to AE. Okay, whenever we have a small angle of deviation, now we can consider AC equals to AE. Okay, AC, AC here, AE here. Okay, suppose if in case of which angle is to, actually we have a triangle here. Okay, we have a right angle triangle here. The angle between these two sides will be very small. If in case of very small, we can equating these two edges. Okay, suppose this is the A, this is the B, this is the C. So if your angle between these two edges will be small, how we can equate these two edges? So AB equals to AC. AB equals to AC. Increase in length of the diagonal. AC equals to the next one. Increase in the length of the diagonal. Diagonal. AC equals to EC dash. Okay. Increase the length of the diagonal. AC equals to, so which is nothing but the actual diagonal will be the AC. After the application of load, what is the delta L will be the EC dash. So EC dash is nothing but the CC dash cos CCE. CC dash will be CC dash cos CCE. CCE is nothing but the, we can call it as a, from the basic mathematical formulas. But angle CCE is nearly equal to the BCA, which is 45 degrees. Okay, angle CCE, CCE, angle CCE is nothing but the here, which is nearly equals to BCA. Here these two equations, these two are the same. These two angles are the same. Okay, so just to derive the equations here, the derivation is minimum. There are so many kinds of derivations here. So we'll go through the. This is very difficult to explain how does it will come. How do you change this? It's we have the same conventions. So, okay, so from first day onwards, we will go. We will have a plan to conduct online classes in a Google Meet or in a live class, okay, not in a recorded class, okay. So this is the relation here also. Now lateral strain of diagonal AC is equals to the. The strain produced by tensile force along AC and plus strain produced by compressible force along BD. E equals to tau by tau is nothing but the shear stress. Okay, tau by E plus tau by ME. So it's nothing but in case of strain along line strain along diagonal AC. So in case of diagonal situation, the shear strain will be acted. That's the reason we go to summation of shear strains in terms of AC, in the direction of AC and in the direction of BD, PD. Okay, in case of AC, sigma tau by E plus in case of BD, the value will be the tau by ME. Here is the also. So tau by E is multiplied by 1 plus 1 by M. The from equation 1 and 2, the tau by E is multiplied by 1 plus 1 by M is equal to 1 by 2 of pi. By equation 1 and 2, here the, this is by equation 1. Here the, we have here equation 1. And here the, we have here equation 2. By equating these two, sum is nothing but we just do 1 by D. CC dash by DC dash DC is equals to 1 by 2 pi is equals to tau by E 1 plus 1 by M. So like this one. By solving these two, we have here a relation here. E equals to 2C into 1 by 1 plus 1 by M. So this is the main, kept aside what is the relation, kept aside what is the derivation, just to remember the formula. Okay. So we are in a basic level. That's why reason I just suggest you just to remember the formula. E equals to 2C into 1 plus 1 by M. Okay. How does it changes? Okay. E equals to 2. There's relation between the E and the C here. We can okay, if in case of relation between the E and K, the consider a cube which is subjected to direct stress on each of the faces. Okay. Direct stress which is acting on each of the faces, and the L equals to length of each side of the cube. Okay. Volume of the cube equals to L cube. So dV is equals to 3 times of L square dL. What is the change in volume equals to 3 times of L square? dL. How it will come? How it initially it has a volume of like this one. Okay. After the application of load, initially we have a volume of like this in a cube. Okay. After application of load, the three directions are getting expanded. Okay. In this direction also, it will expanded. Okay. Some amount. So how which amount? L into L. Area. Cross-section area is which is multiplied by volume. So initially, what is meant by what is the volume of the cube? What is the volume of the cube? L into B into H is nothing but the the cross section area is multiplied by length, okay? Whether it is right or wrong, is it it or not? So volume equals to cross section area into length. That's why reason here also after the application of load also now we need to calculate what is the change in volume. So here also here the one side will be the cross section area into L. So here the three sides are there. That's why reason 3 into cross section area is nothing but the L square under DL. Okay. So by just deriving with the volume, we just applying the derivations here. So what will be the answer? The 3 L square delta L by L cube here. So volume equals to L cube. So dV by V equals to 3 times of delta L by L. 3 times of delta L by L. Okay. Now here though we can observe that the overall volume volumetric strain is equals to 3 times of linear strain. Okay. Consider the effect of mutual perpendicular stresses on the side of DD. So the strain of DC due to the stress sigma along X equals to sigma by E. So in case of X direction, stress along DC, suppose where it is DC. So this is the D and this is the C. Okay, so the strain of DC due to stress of along due to stress of sigma. DC is nothing but the here this plane. What is my what is the strain due to the stress of sigma? Okay, equals to sigma by E. Okay, the strain of DC due to stress sigma along Z equals to minus of sigma by ME. The total strain of DC equals to sigma by E minus sigma by ME minus sigma by ME. In nothing but the respective directions sigma x initially the sigma x by E minus sigma y by ME minus sigma z by ME. The total change in length equals to change in length original length equals to E by sigma by E by just keeping a common 1 minus 2 by M. Here equation we can call it as a equation 2. From equation 1 and 2 we have a dv by v is equal to 3 times of delta L by L minus 3 sigma by E and 1 minus 2 by M here. So we just to simply dv by v is nothing but the change in volumetric strain. Okay, 3 sigma by E 1 minus 2 by M here. How does it will come? So we just simply derive in this. Okay, 3 times of delta L by L is nothing but the delta L equals to here delta L by L is sigma by E 1 minus 2 by M. Okay, we just substitute this equation here and then later we derived here. Okay, or 1 by K is nothing but the K is nothing but the bulk modulus. Bulk modulus you can call it as a direct stress by volumetric strain. Sigma y by sigma, ex by sigma, 3 times of e by 1 minus 2 by m. So k equals to direct stress by volumetric strain. So direct stress equals to, we can call it 1 by k here. We just consider 1 by k here. The direct stress equals to sigma. So the answer will be the volumetric strain by sigma. Okay, volumetric strain equals to, already we know, 3 sigma by e, 1 minus 2 by m by sigma. So sigma getting cancelled, the answer will be the 3 by E, 1 minus 2 by M. Why? Because sigma getting cancelled here. Okay. E equals to 3K of 1 minus 2 by M. So 3K, E equals to, just keeping the here. Okay. E equals to keeping the E in left side direction and brings the K in the right side direction. 3 E equals to, the final equation will be that E equals to 3K of 1 minus 2 by M here. This is the another equation. This is the one more equation here we need to understand, we need to remember. And okay, finally we have a suppose up to now we have discussed about the two concepts, the relation between the E and K, the relation between the E and the C. What is meant by C? C is nothing but the modulus of rigidity. C is just by C strength. Okay? So E equals to 2C into 1 plus 1 by M. Okay? We just remember 2C into 1 plus 1 by M. If in case of relation between the E and K, the formula will be E equals to 3K into 1 minus 2 by M. Okay, here is the 1 plus 1 by M. Here is the 1 minus 2 by M. We just remember. And the next final one is the up to now we have individually deriving the relation between the two parameters only. And now we are going to deriving the three parameters. Okay, what is the relation between these three iterations? Okay, E, C and K. The relation between the E, C and given by the equation, we can call it the E equals to 2C into 1 plus 1 by M here. Or we can just bring the 2C term to the left side direction, which is E by 2C equals to 1 plus 1 by M. We just call it as the one first equation. And then next to the relation between the E and K is given by the equation is equals to E equals to 3K times of 1 minus 2 by M here. So just simply substituting this equation here. Okay. So by equating these two equations, okay, we can call it as just to bring the 3K term into the left side direction, the answer will be the 1 minus 2 by M is equals to E by 3K. Okay. Initially, this is the first equation equals to E by 2C of 1 plus 1 by M. And the here the E by 3K of 1 minus 2 by M. From equation 1 and 2. So 1 and 2 by deriving, how do we deriving this? By just multiplying the first equation with the 2. Okay. And then second equation as usual. So 2 times of EC, 2 into E by E 2C. So 2 getting cancelled. And okay. And then equation will be the 3 equals to E by C plus E by 3K. E by C here. So while how do we change the why we are going to multiplying with 2? Why? Because here the 1 plus 1 by M here. Here is the 1 plus 2 by M here. So we need to cancel these two. Okay. We need to cancel these two terms. So how do we change this from the basic mathematics? So you just simply simply 1 plus 1 by M multiplied by 2. The answer will be the 2 plus 2 by M. Okay. So it's a 2 plus 2 by M. It's a 1 plus 2, 1 minus 2 by M. So we can calculate, we can getting cancelled. Okay. And here also, the final deriving equation will be the 3 equals to E by C plus 3 by EK, 3K. So here the 3 equals to 3 EK by 3 EK. We just common the C and EK, 3K. So 3 CK, just to see 3 EK plus E. And then remaining equation will be the E equals to E 3 equals to E times of 3K plus C by 3CK. The final equation will be here. This is the final equation. Up to now, this is the final equation. We need to remember three equations here. First one is the relation between the E and C. And the second one is the relation between the E and K. Okay. And the final will be, the final answer will be, final equation will be the E equals to 9KC by 3K plus C. So wherever you go, this is the main formulas for the relation between the elastic constants. Okay, so E equals to 2C into 1 plus 1 by M is the first equation, and E equals to 3K into 1 minus 2 by M is the second equation, and the E equals to 9KC by 3K plus C. Okay, this is the third equation. So you need to remember these three equations apart from the derivatives. Okay, remaining part we will discuss later.